the Honda Rancher ES is at the end of its life, due to soon be replaced by an all-new 400cc model with the hydraulic automatic transmission, much like what's in the Rubicon. But until then, the Rancher's left to do battle in the 400cc class with a mere 329 cc's and an electric shift 5-speed transmission. Now, the Rancher's a clean and simple design and a small overall package, even for a 400-class ATV. The air and oil-cooled engine is turned sideways so that the engine and drive shaft turn the same direction, thereby causing less power loss. The electric shift transmission is basically an auto-clutch 5-speed with electric servos controlled by the left handlebar-mounted switches for shifting through the gears. The suspension is dual A-arms up front with 5.9 inches of travel and a single swing arm in the rear, also with 5.9 inches of travel. Now, oddly enough, the shocks are non-adjustable and the brakes, front and rear, are sealed drums. The seating is low at only 32.5 inches and the weight low at 535 pounds dry, making the Rancher an easy machine to manhandle both in the rough stuff and on the fast trails. The Rancher comes with as complete a gauge package as any ATV, with a digital speedometer, odometer, trip odometer, clock, and hour meter. And also included in the display is the gear selected by the tranny. Climbing on, there's no doubt that the Rancher is small, but yet it's still comfortable even for the larger riders. The engine starts easy and sounds fantastic. You know, every time we talk about how ATVs should sound, it always seems like it's a Honda that sets an example that we measure the others by. Now, the electric shift selects gears with a thunk that's alarming enough to make you feel like a rookie about to send gear pieces through the side case. But our experience has shown it to be nothing less than bulletproof. The reverse mechanism is probably one of the hardest to use, having to push a button on the left brake lever as you pull it in and shift the button down from neutral. It's hard to explain and even harder to do in a hurry or in a bind. Also a nuisance is the fact that the Rancher doesn't start in gear, probably the only ATVs left on the planet that don't. Other than the gauges and the longitudinal engine, there's nothing remotely trick about the little Honda, so it's no surprise that it has a reputation as tried and true. Even more amazing is how well all this ordinary stuff works when assembled at a Honda plant. The Rancher proves to be absolutely amazing to ride in the extreme stuff, due no doubt to the combination of its small size, low seat height, and good front differential. Unfortunately, there's another area where the Rancher is lacking. There's no way to take the system out of four-wheel drive. The Honda's minimal suspension travel and old-fashioned drum brakes also won't give you any clue by looking at the spec sheets how well they work out on the trail, as the overall balance between the front and rear suspensions and the surprisingly good feel from the brakes make the Rancher one of the fastest 400cc class machines in the twisties and on the fast trails. Now, while good at speed or loaded with gear, the Honda is simply too stiffly sprung to be a joy at slow speeds on bumpy trails. The simple tubing racks offer the best possible combination of load fastening, and even their height off the plastic is beneficial when tying loads down or washing the ATV. So while the Rancher appears to be nothing out of the ordinary, once again, it's the assembly of the pieces that makes the difference. The seat fits your bottom, the handlebars are right where they should be, and all the switchgear work with smooth precision, and the engine has more power than its small size leads you to believe. So although the Rancher is still a great machine, today's ultra-competitive market requires new machines with all the newest features to compete successfully for our hard-earned money. The good? Honda quality, Honda ergonomics, great gauges, wonderful sound. The bad? It doesn't start in gear, no two-wheel drive option, and silly reverse operation. The bottom line? Although showing its age, the Rancher is still amazingly enough a better whole than the sum of its parts would suggest.